Welcome you all. I am Srinath Salyan, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering Department of Canara Engineering College. In this lecture, I will explain about dimensional analysis. In that introduction about the dimensional analysis and what is the procedure to solve the numericals on this dimensional analysis. Hello everyone, on today's class I will give the information about dimensional analysis. So this is lecture number 1 on dimensional analysis. The dimension analysis is a method of dimensions. It is a mathematical technique used in research work for design and for conducting model tests. In previous 2 lectures we discussed about model analysis. In model analysis, the performance analysis are studied of a model based on the different properties of the fluid flow. So in order to study that performance, so this one tool is used for using the dimensions of various parameters or properties of the fluid flow. It is deals with dimensions of the physical quantities involved in the phenomenon, such as that is directly influence on the physical quantities that will influence on the fluid flow. So commonly length L, mass M, and time t are the fixed dimensions, so which are most important in fluid mechanics. So these 3 dimensions are taken as the base dimensions or primary dimensions. In case heat transfer problems, so at that time the temperature is also taken into consideration. At that time, so this temperature is also taken as fixed dimension. These fixed dimensions are called fundamental dimensions, primary dimensions, or fundamental quantity. Next, secondary or derived dimensions. So these secondary or derived dimensions are those which possesses more than one fundamental dimension. For example, we take the velocity. Here velocity is denoted by meter per unit time. That is meter per second. That is the meter, the length is denoted by L and time is denoted by T. For that reason it is L by T. Density. The density is the ratio of mass by volume. The mass is denoted by M and volume is denoted by L power 3. So similar, the acceleration, that is distance per second square, the distance is denoted by L, that is meter is denoted by L, by time square, that is T power 2. In this terms, in terms of velocity, density and acceleration. So if there are 2 fundamental dimensions or quantities are there, so for that reason, so that means the secondary or derived quantities are consist of 2 or more number of fundamental dimensions. So these expressions L by T, M by L power 3 and L by T power 2 are called dimensions of velocity, density and acceleration respectively. So these are secondary or derived quantities. Next, coming to the some physical quantities here, the dimensions of physical quantities. The first one, fundamental dimension, that is the length, mass and time. The symbols used for that one, L, M, T, the length, L for length, M for mass, T for time. And dimensions for that one, length L, mass M, time T. So these are called as fundamental or primary quantity. If geometric quantity is taken, so that is area and volume, the symbols used for area A, volume V, and dimensions, the area, the unit of area is meter square, that is L square, length square. The unit of volume is meter cube, that is L cube, or length cube. Next, some other physical quantities. In that one, the kinematic quantities. The kinematic quantity, so almost these are all called as the derived quantities. Velocity, the symbol used V, and dimensions L, that is meter per second, so that is meter, the distance is denoted by L. Time T, that is meter per second, meter L, the T is taken to numerator and they come to T power minus 1. So that is one simple example to write the dimensions of any quantity. So the totally their dimensions are written based on the unit of that quantity. The velocity is given by meter per second, that is L into T power minus 1. Similarly, angular velocity, symbol used omega, and unit, so 1 by time, the T power minus 1. Acceleration A, unit of that one meter per second square, meter L into T power minus 2. Angular acceleration A, that once again T power minus 2. Discharge, the discharge is given by this denoted by Q, symbol used Q. And the unit of the discharge is meter cube per second. Meter cube per second, the meter cube, that is L cube, into T power minus 1. Acceleration due to gravity, G. Dimensions, L into T power minus 2. Kinematic viscosity, that is nu. The unit of that, meter square per second, L square into T power minus 1. Next, dynamic quantities, force, denoted by symbol F, unit or dimensions of that, M into L into T power minus 2, weight, W, dimensions, M, L, T power minus 2, density, rho, M into L power minus 3, specific weight, omega, then a small omega, that is M into L power minus 2, T power minus 2, dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity mu, M into L power minus 1 into T power minus 1, pressure intensity P, M into L power minus 1, T power minus 2. So the modulus of elasticity, E or denoted by symbol E or K, dimensions M into L power minus 1, T power minus 2. Surface tension denoted by sigma, that is M into T power minus 2. So these are the dynamic quantities, shear stress is the tau, this is the dimensions. Similarly, work and energy denoted by W or E. Then power, P, so these are dimensions. Torque, T, it is given by the dimension M into L power 2, T power minus 2. Last, momentum, it is M, and dimensions M into L into T power minus 1. So these are the dimensions for physical quantities. Then dynamic quantities as well as the kinematic quantities. Next one important, the method is used to solve the dimension in dimension analysis, that is the Buckingham Pi theorem. So commonly, basically Rayleigh's method of dimension analysis is used, but here we find very difficult to solve the all the numericals because of what, in case the large number of variables are influenced on the numericals. So at that time we are going for the Buckingham Pi theorem. The statement from the Buckingham theorem, if there are n variables, it includes both independent and dependent variables in a physical phenomenon, and if these variables contain m fundamental dimensions, and that is the fundamental dimensions L, M, T, then variables are arranged into n minus m dimensionless term. Each term is called pi terms. For example, if 6 different variables are present in a phenomenon, so at that time the n is equals to 6. So in that there are 3 fundamental variables, that is L, M and T. So that is given by M is equals to 3. So now total number of pi terms is given by N minus M. That means 6 minus 3 is equals to 3. There are 3 different pi terms are involved in the particular numerical. So that is the statement of Buckingham Pi theorem. Let x1, x2, x3 to the xn are the variables involved in the physical phenomena. The x1 be the dependent variable. So there are 2 types of the variables. One is a dependent variable and the rest of the variables are for independent variables. Here x1 be the dependent variable and x2, x3 and remaining up to xn are the independent variables. So we can write this one as the x1 is a function of x2, x3 to xn. Take that expression number 1, which can be written as f1 is a function on x2, x3 up to xn p is equals to 0. That expression is taken as now. Equation 2 is dimensionally homogeneous equation. That means dimensionally homogeneous equation means the left hand side of the expression and right hand side of the equation or expression become same. That is the dimension, it is same. It contains n variables. If there are m fundamental dimensions, then according to Buckingham Pi theorem, equation 2 can be written in the form of number of dimensionless group or pi terms, which in term that is the pi terms, that is n minus m. Already I told that is the number of pi terms in the Buckingham terms is equals to n minus m. That means number of variables minus number of fundamental variables. So here LMT, that is called as fundamental dimensions. So finally this one is written as first 5n term is written as x2 power of a1, x3 power of b1, x4 power of c1 into x1. So here a1, b1, c1, these are arbitrary terms that is used for our to solve this numericals in easier method. It is taken as a1, b1, c1. For the next 5-2 term, it is taken as a2, b2, c2. Similarly, for n terms, that is a 5, n minus m is equals to x power of a, n minus m, b, n minus m, c, m into x4, that is a, once again n minus m into xn. After writing these, the dimensions of each variables, so now the values of a1, b1, c1, etc. are obtained by the simplification by taking the dimensional homogeneity. Then these values are substituted, the obtained a1, b1, c1 values are substituted in equation number 4, that is the 5-1, 5-2, 5-3 terms. And 5 terms are substituted in the equation number 3. So finally it is written in the 5-1 term is a function of 5-2, 5-3, 5 into n minus 1. So these are the method of writing the dependent variable on independent 5 terms. Next, the method of selecting the repeating variables in available number of variables. See here, the number of repeating variables are equal to the number of fundamental dimensions of the problems. So actually here the fundamental repeating variables are taken from the fundamental dimensions. The dependent variables should not be selected as repeating variables. So in given numerical, the dependent variable should not be selected as the repeating variables. That means you have to select the repeating variables only from the list of independent variables. The repeating variable should be taken from one variable from the geometric property, one variable from the flow property, and next one from fluid property. So your geometric property variables are consist of length, diameter and height. Flow property variables consist of velocity and acceleration. Fifth one, the fluid property, which consists of viscosity, density, specific weight. So these are the list of the geometric property, flow property as well as fluid property. So these repeating variables should be taken from each group. That means one variable from the geometric property, one variable from the flow property, then one more variable from the fluid property. So don't take the two variables from the same group. The repeating variables should not form dimensionless form. Always remember, repeating a variable should not form any dimensionless group. Repeating variables together must have same number of fundamental dimensions here. So one more thing, two repeating variables should have the same dimension. That means don't take the same two variables from the single group or single property. The common the repeating variables are like that. The D, V, rho. So in that one, the D represents the diameter, the V is equals to velocity, rho is equals to density. So here the diameter is taken from the geometric property, the velocity is taken from the flow property, the density is taken from the fluid property. And similarly in the second one, L, V, rho. In that one, the L represents length. Length, that is geometric property, V, velocity, rho, density. So here, third one, L, V, mu, so length, velocity and viscosity. The fourth one, diameter, velocity and viscosity. So this is a common method of selecting the repeating variables here. So this is just information related to dimension analysis. Then primary quantities, secondary quantities, then dimensions of the different quantities, then information related to Buckingham Pi theorem to solve the numericals, and the method of getting the repeating variables. On next topic in lecture number 2, so I will give the information to how to solve the problems by using the Buckingham Pi theorem. Thank you.